Hey guys, what's up? Jeremy Schaefer here. Well, today I'm going to show you how to fold an origami heart, you guessed it, flasher. And yes, it's a heart flasher that I designed a long time ago, but I never diagrammed or published. So I'm going to show you how to fold it now. It's a rather difficult model, so I'd recommend first trying one of my easier flashers, like this one. And all right, here we go. So this model is folded from a 10-inch square of commie. You could try it from a 6-inch, but I recommend a 10-inch. This one is white on one side, but you could even use an 8.5 by 11 sheet of printer paper. So, okay, colored side up. Let's fold in half. Try to make very exact folds and crease sharply. Okay, unfold. And we're going to make a grid of 16. So let's fold this edge to the crease. First, we're going to do fourths. Unfold and rotate 180 degrees, and let's fold this edge to the middle. And unfold, and now let's fold this edge to the last crease. And unfold, and let's fold the edge to the first crease. And let's leave it folded and rotate 180 degrees and let's fold this edge to the first crease. And unfold, and now let's fold this edge to this edge. And now completely unfold. And let's turn over right to left and lift up, not the first crease, but let's lift up the second crease. So it's a fold. And let's fold it onto the first crease. So fold it up and flatten. And you see when we do that, we make a crease in between. Okay, now let's take the next crease down and let's lift this up and fold it onto this edge. And flatten. And let's just continue all the way down. So lift this crease up and fold it up. And this one. And if I'm going too fast, well, you can pause and do this at your own speed. Okay, and lastly, fold this edge to the middle. And turn over right to left. And fold this flap down on this crease and fold this edge up to here. And open, and voila, we have 16 divisions. We have it divided into 16. Okay, now let's rotate 90 degrees. And now we're going to do it in this direction, but we want to avoid making a horizontal crease on the heart. So when we do this fold, don't crease it all the way across. Just fold 6 units. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. And 6 on this side. You could do 7, but let's play it safe with 6 units. Okay. And unfold, and now we're going to continue dividing it into 16. So let's first do fourths, like we did before, and rotate, and let's fold this up, and unfold, and let's fold this edge to this crease. And unfold and fold it up to the first crease and leave it folded and rotate 180 degrees and let's fold this edge up to the first crease. And unfold. And now let's fold this edge up to the edge. And unfold. And turn over right to left. Now instead of starting up here, we're going to start not in the center, but on the crease right below the center. So lift it up. It's the third crease from the bottom. Lift it up and fold it onto the center. And that's just so that we don't accidentally make this middle crease. Okay, and let's lift the next one down, lift it up, and place it onto the edge. And lift this fold up to right here. And fold the raw edge to here. Okay, let's rotate 180 degrees and let's do the same thing on this side. So lift it up and fold it onto here. And continue all the way down. And fold the raw edge to the middle. Okay, crease sharply and unfold. And let's turn over right to left. And let's rotate 45 degrees. And let's fold this corner to the second to last intersection point. So not here, but to here. And let's just come down here and let's just fold four units. So two in this direction and two in that direction. So once again, we came down the center. We found the center point right here and we creased two units in this direction and two units in that. So one, two, three, four units were folded. Okay, and unfold and rotate 90 degrees and let's do the same thing on this corner. So fold it up to this intersection and bring your finger right down to the center and two in this direction and two in this direction. Okay, and unfold and let's repeat on this corner. There and rotate and let's do the last corner. All right, now let's hold it up. Okay, so here we have our crease. I don't know if you can see it. There should be a crease right here, horizontal, but not a crease vertical. That's the one that we intentionally did not make. So orient it like this. Now we're going to work on this corner of the square. This is the center square. And what we're going to do is form this horizontal edge. So extend the bottom edge of this square. Extend it to the right. And extend this right edge down like this. And now we're going to bring these two edges together. And I have my hand underneath to provide support. So here we go. We just squeeze them together, and that makes a valley fold in between, just like that. Okay? And so we just made these two folds. And now what we're going to do, squeeze it, And now we're going to make the next mountain folds here and here. And squeeze these two edges together a little bit more, like that. Okay, and this is what we have. And if you can, this valley fold, let's extend this out. So just fold it like this. So here we have like the front of a truck. Something like that. Okay, let's do the same thing to the left side. So let's find our top square again. Okay, right here. Let's go to the left corner and extend this edge to the left. And let's extend the left edge down. And let's squeeze these two together. So we make this valley fold here. And now let's make these two valley folds by pushing the paper in and continue squeezing. And we have it like this. And let's make this valley. Let's extend this out like we did before. Okay, and this is what it should look like. And from the underside, it should look like this. Okay, so there we have this side, and we have our horizontal crease there. Okay, let's rotate, and let's do the same thing on this side. And I'm going to go a little bit faster on this side, because hopefully you will have already done it. Okay, so here's the corner. We squeeze these two together. And we squeeze it together like that. And here we have the front of the truck. Okay. And let's do it on this side. Squeeze these two edges together. And make these valley folds. And there we have this side of the truck. So what we have is a cube sticking out, a cubicle cabin of the truck. Okay, so now what we're going to do is squeeze this together like this, and we're going to squash this down, being careful not to make this fold. So just squeeze and squeeze these edges together and flatten this down like this. And flatten it this direction. Okay? so it looks like a table of some sort. And now we're going to hold it like this and separate these two edges like this so it looks like two pleats. Well, it is two pleats. So hold that in one hand. And let's do the same thing on this side. So make this pleat here, and this here, okay? And now what you want to do is separate your hands like this, okay? And flatten it down. And there we have it. So what we have is we have this crease here, but it's actually attached by paper that's going horizontal. Okay, now let's fold the thing in half, but let's not fold this top square. So just fold this whole top part behind, but leaving the square up like this. And now let's mountain fold right down the middle, the whole thing in half. This is going to be the heart right here. So let's work on making it look more like a heart. So what we're going to do is make a reverse fold here. Now, for guidelines, just estimate that we have thirds here. So what we're going to do is do a reverse fold right here. If you want, you can first fold it over right onto the third mark and unfold and open and reverse fold it. So just push it in right on that crease, and there's the crevice of the heart. Let's do the right and left sides. So just fold it, fold the corners behind. Like that, and there's the top of the heart. And now let's open and let's flip this thing behind like this. And let's rotate 180 degrees. And now we're going to make the point of the heart. We're on the back side. So let's do a paper airplane fold. So bring these corners in like this. And let's unfold and let's fold this edge to the crease. And unfold and let's fold this edge to the crease. And let's fold the flaps in on the existing creases and flatten it really well. All right, so let's turn it over. Let's flip the heart behind like this. All right, now what we're going to do is take this edge and put your finger in here and make a mountain fold that goes from here all the way to the edge. And now we're going to take this paper, this edge right here, and we're going to fold it to this edge. And we'll be making a valley fold, a diagonal valley fold in between. So it's like that. And you can see it comes out one unit from this edge, so it doesn't hit the corner. So that's what it looks like. Okay, and now we're going to do the same thing. Take this edge right here and fold it to this edge, and we'll make a diagonal valley fold coming down this way. Like that. Okay, and now we're going to make some reverse folds. So, let's first crease it nice and sharply. Okay, and now let's open this up, and we're going to take this paper right here and reverse fold it on this existing crease and this existing crease. So we just bring it down here, and let's reverse the crease like that. So now it's sticking out, and now we're going to reverse it back in on this fold and this fold. Like that. And let's reverse again on these two folds. And one last time, like this. Okay, so that's the flasher pattern there. And now let's do the same thing, but on this larger flap. So let's reverse fold on here and here. And reverse the crease so that the flap is sticking out. And now let's reverse it again on this crease. And again on this crease. And again. And again. Okay, crease it sharply. So that's what it looks like. And just for fun, let's try to curve this around. So just make mountain folds like this. And you can make mountain folds in between each one of them. We're basically just trying to get it to curve. It'll make it hopefully easier when we try to roll up the flasher. Okay, so it's nice and compact and curved. All right, let's unfold these pleats here and go back to how it was, like that. Hopefully you'll be able to refold them pretty easily. So let's turn over and let's do the same thing on this side. But first let's pivot the heart back like this. Okay, and let's lift this flap up and let's form the mountain fold. And let's bring this to here. Making the diagonal fold. And let's fold this edge to here. Okay. So we have the two diagonals. And now let's do our reverse folds. So, reverse once and twice. And if I'm going too fast, you can pause it. Hopefully you get the idea by this point. So, now we do the next one. Okay, and let's curve it, let's curl it. Okay, and now unfold it. And now let's just try to bring these folds back again. So this, well, you have the folds already in place, so just remake them. All right, and now just push the thing together. And it should wrap around just a single two-unit segment. And it won't be perfect, that's the nature of flashers, but just try to do your best. Just squeeze. Okay, now let's look at the bottom here and try to find the center. It's right there. And just open it up put your finger in. And now try to make this crease right here, try to make it stick out. So what we want to do is we want to press the two sides of the heart and try to make the center here pull out. And that'll make the thing just sort of become three-dimensional. And this becomes circular. And this is our crevice. So it's just like that. And if you want, you can try to blow on this to open up, fill out the heart a little bit. Like that. And there is the flasher. And it should turn a full rotation or more. So yeah, and this is one that I made that's from a 6-inch square. And I was able to turn this into a flasher deluxe. Now, I'm definitely not going to teach this. It was a little bit messy, but this is, it's an operation. You can put a heart on a flasher, and you can also make the deluxe pattern. Although I'm not going to teach it, I do have a tutorial for a flasher deluxe right here. All right, so there is the heart flasher. And I hope you find this useful for your romantic escapades. It's a, good for a birthday present or for Valentine's Day. And yeah, well, let me know what you think. And hopefully you guys were able to fold this model. If not, well, let me know where you got stuck and I'll try to help you out with an annotation. All right, see you later. Bye.